big shocking news has just come in recently that the M2 iMac might be delayed for the M3 chipset instead. Today, I want to go over all the details of this report and go over the specs, design, and of course, I want to go over the iMac 2022 release date and price as well. But first, a quick summary of where we are with the iMac. So Apple updated the only remaining iMac in 2021 with a whole new design with a 24.5-inch display with the M1 chipset inside. The design is the thinnest iMac that has ever been created, and it's gone back to its old late 90s roots of adding lots of color choices that you can pick from. The iMac is a great home PC Mac for anyone who needs to browse the web or do some amateur photo, music, or video editing, as the M1 chipset can more than cope with these tasks on an ad hoc basis. Well, we have some more great news, and that Apple are looking to enhance the new designed iMac with a couple of new features and of course putting the next generation M2 chipset inside, what has just been announced at WWDC. So with that M2 journey, what has now begun with the M2 MacBook Pro and that brand new design MacBook Air with an M2 inside coming, the M2 chipset offers around about 18% more CPU performance than we had on the M1. But for GPU, we're gaining up to 35% more power when you pick that new 10-core GPU option. As you can imagine, it's logical for Apple to apply this chipset into their remaining Macs and devices that have an M1 chipset already. So I'm talking about the iMac 24-inch, Mac Mini, iPad Pro, and of course the iPad Air. But remember, all of these devices may take a year or even a bit more to get the upgrades to M2, especially with the iPad Air, as that was the last device to get the M1 chipset, and that was only a few months ago. It's more than likely that the next devices to get the M2 chipset will be the iPad Pro, Mac Mini, and the iMac. However, an unusual report has come in from Mark Gurman claiming that the next iMac will not be getting an M2 chipset, but in fact an M3 chipset based on a 3-nanometer die instead. However, Gurman is claiming that this will not come out until at the earliest late 2023 alongside an M3, MacBook Air, and other Mac models. If this does come true, this might be a big blow on the iMac, as already at the time of making this video, it's already 15 months old, and by October this year, or basically the fall of this year, it will be over 18 months old. Gurman said that the M3 is coming at the earliest of fall 2023, so this would mean if the iMac skipped the M2 chipset, then it would be 2.5 years at the earliest that we will see a new chipset put inside this. So it could even be 3 years or more if the M3 journey started in 2024, for example. Gurman does also have a good record of being correct, but has on multiple times before the launch of a device changed his mind on when products will come out. So it'll be interesting to see in the next couple of months or so if he does change his mind or we get any other leaks and reports from other leakers out there. Me, I believe Apple would be missing out on a massive opportunity, missing out putting the M2 inside the iMac in the next 6 months. If Apple did skip over the M2 chipset, then I believe sales would dry up very soon as we're approaching full time, and also that as we got options of the M2 and M2 Pro in the Mac Mini and other devices, these will sell more than the iMac. Then, for example, if we had to wait another 12 months again to get that M3 chipset inside the iMac, it does seem really, really crazy, and iMac sales will just be non-existent. But with all of this, a quick note, with any of these leaks, even up to the new iMac release date, with all these reports and leaks, they're not 100% proof that they will come true with the new iMac. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the next iMac anyway. So then guys, just recently, this channel just got over 400,000 subscribers, and I did a giveaway for a MacBook Air M1, and if you want to see who the winner was for that MacBook Air 1, check out my other video on my channel where I announce who the winner is. But the great thing is guys, I am doing another giveaway on this channel, and it is for this is for a 14-inch MacBook Pro, and this is with an M1 Pro chipset inside it, the 8-core one with a 14-core GPU and a 512GB hard drive inside. And I'm going to be giving this away now to one lucky subscriber when we get over 450,000 subscribers. And to enter into this international giveaway, all I need you guys to do is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy or other technology gear in 2022. Put it down in the comments below. And also guys, if you are brand new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 450,000 subscribers, I'll be announcing who the winner is of this MacBook Pro, and you won't want to miss out on that video. Now, something else just want to quickly say, sadly still on YouTube, there are lots of scammers and spammers out there, some of them even impersonating myself, telling you to WhatsApp them or to Telegram you or other means as well. Ignore them, or please do report them. It would really, really help, because we don't want scammers and spammers getting their way here on YouTube. Well, guys, with that out of the way, let's return back to the video. So, release date's next, and as the M1 journey in all Macs is complete and we now have started the M2 journey with the new MacBook Pro and that new design MacBook Air, the next devices to be upgraded from the Macs is going to be the iMac and the Mac Mini. As Apple already started a journey similar to the M1, it's likely these are the next devices to be updated to an M2 chipset. Apple normally hold an event in September time that is more primarily for Apple's watches, iPads, and also the iPhones. However, we normally get another event around mid to end October time showcasing the new Macs that come out around about the end of October to early November time. It's expected for Apple to release the new M2 Macs at this time. So, with that out of the way, let's talk about the iMac specs along with the price. So starting out, as already mentioned, the actual design is probably going to be staying the same for the iMac, just like we had with the M1 iMac that came out in 2021. But this basically means we'll be getting that same 23.5-inch LED Retina display, what we basically call is a 24-inch display. And the resolution of the display is a 4480 by 2520. This is a standard LED Retina display. It's not a mini LED display like in what we get in, say, the MacBook Pro, the 14-inch and 16-inch, and also that 12.9-inch iPad. So it's not going to be that. It's the same display as we've had before. But the great news is the pixels per inch will be 218. We'll have storage options between 256 gigabytes all the way up to 2 terabytes, depending on what kind of configuration that you pick. But the actual chipset inside it will be that brand new M2 8-core CPU, what is made up of 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. And then you will also get the GPU, what will be up to 10 cores this time, 10 graphical cores, up from the up to 8 cores that we used to get in the M1 chipset. We will also get the choice between of 8GB or 16GB of RAM again, and the actual body will be an aluminium body, and then on the back we will have ports of either a choice of 2 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, or if you go for a higher configuration you will get the 2x USB-C ports, what are USB 3, and you will also get those 2x Thunderbolt 4 ports, and you will also get a 1 gigabit Ethernet port, what's actually built into the power block, what you can like stick on the floor, for example. The colors will basically be the same again, and Apple could introduce a new color this year, so we'll have to wait and see on that. But the colors as they stand right now is blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange, and purple. But like I said, they could introduce a whole new color, so we have to wait and see on that one. For the webcam, there's going to be a slight upgrade here. We're going to be getting a 1080p center stage camera now, because we do have the M1 chipset inside it and it can kind of handle sort of image processing bits and pieces. It makes sense for this to be upgraded to this. With price though, starting out with an 8GB of RAM configuration, and this is the lower spec M2 chipset, if you chose 256GB of storage, this will come in at $1,299, and then 512GB will be $1,499, and then for example 1TB would be $1,699. So, as you can see, Apple built the foundations of the M1 iMac and made it better here with the M2 iMac. So next are my wishes for the iMac M2, and really it's to do with the price. Right now, the M1 iMac starts at $1,299, but I fear that Apple may actually increase the price this year by putting that M2 chipset inside it. I really, really hope they don't do this. They might slap on an extra $100, but I'm really hoping that the starting price will remain the same at $1,299 and it shouldn't increase at all. But those are my thoughts and wishes. Do you agree with that? Let me know in the comments below because I'd love to know your thoughts. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to press the like button, and at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by that notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon.